All right, what's going on, guys? My name's Alex Wittick, and this is my Purple Mark V Jetta TDI. So today, I actually have a fun video planned. I needed to get these seats, these full containment Recaro Han seats, out of the car. I think I'm just gonna do the passenger side for now because I really only need to find out what size lock washers to get. The passenger seat doesn't get saddened as much as the driver's seat, and I don't know, but for some reason, the driver's side, two outer bolts tend to come loose. And yeah, they're grade 8 bolts and stuff like that, so they're strong, but for some reason they just come loose, and I'm not gonna throw thread locker in there or anything like that. So I wanna take the seat out, find out what size lock washers I'm gonna need, and then address that situation. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and take that seat out, and we'll see what else we can do to the car today. There's a lot of stuff I can do to it, and think about future videos and stuff like that. Open the door. Now this bolt is tight, and I actually just tightened up this bolt not too long ago, but as you can see, it's hand tight. These are stock Volkswagen bolts, and on the other side, there's lower clearance, so I've actually got the grade 8 bolts over there. But I got this seat just hard mounted, and the seat over there is actually, it's on sliders, so I can move the seat really close to the front or really far back, which is super nice to have Recaro sliders, but yeah, so I gotta actually just pop this off and see what we're working with. I might just pop the whole seat out of the car though. All right, so after I took this bolt out by hand, what do you know? I'm gonna throw that bolt right there. But this whole seat, when I jerk it back and forth, it shouldn't be moving like that. The only reason it's moving like that is there's no back bolt. But then I look down here, and this bolt, now that it's been given some room to move, comes out fully by hand. I'm gonna pop that there. Now the whole seat just moves completely freely, which means that those bolts are loose as well. So we're gonna need to fix that. All right, so I'm just gonna pop this seat out of the car. Seats are super light. Slide right out very easily. Okay, so there we have it. A Recaro Han's full containment seat. Right now, I actually just run a regular seatbelt, so I made this bracket for it as well, and I'll go into detail on that in a better lighting. All right, so I've just got the seat sitting on a milk crate, and this is still the passenger seat, and the bracket is actually a planted bracket. I think this bracket was like $180, got two of them, so they're quite affordable, and they've got some pretty nice MIG welds on there. They're not TIG welds or nothing like that, but they're not bad. And the seat bracket comes with a bracket for the seat belt already welded on, and I used the existing seat belt clip itself with the wiring so it doesn't set off the seat belt light, and I just drilled out the existing hole a little bit bigger to accept this grade 8 bolt so it can mount right up to the existing hole size inside of the mount that's already welded on. Wire runs cleanly underneath the seat and then to there, and then it plugs in on the other side, so it's actually really nice. And then I've got these Recaro adjustable brackets that mount up to the bracket that mounts to the car. And I've actually got the seat mounted quite level. These seats, I got them in really good condition. I actually got them out of a Ferrari or a Porsche of some sort. It was this guy's track car. He was a dentist and he sold the business and he like bought a bunch of cars and stuff. And was trying to, I guess, thin out his little car collection, because I wound up buying these seats for a fairly good deal from the guy that was storing all of his cars. And this passenger seat actually came inside of the plastic packaging. There was a plastic bag over it, and it maybe was opened at once, but it had never been mounted in a car, which was super cool, because this seat was FIA. I think it has the thing on it, year and month, and these seats were made in 2011 in December. So These seats were only FIA rated, I think, till 2012. And yeah, standard FIA seats. So these seats were really nice. The cushions in them are sick. And yeah, I'm just gonna mount this back up into the car for now, since I know the bolt size. And I can go to the store one of these days and just get some washers and stuff like that. But I thought I'd just show you guys what kind of seats I had in the car and what kind of condition they were in, and that they still had the original sticker on there, which is super cool. And like I said, these are the Recaro Han's full containment halo seats for your helmet and stuff like that. And one of the biggest comments I got on Instagram or YouTube, or not really YouTube, no one ever comments on because I never talk about seats, but like TikTok, is, oh my God, why do you have those race car seats in there? But at the end of the day, the Tilted TDI is a show car. That is the whole thing about it. So car only drives maybe 3,000 miles a year, and 3,000 miles a year is generous. I really want the car to just become a trailer queen and yeah, just have fun with it. Not a trailer queen, but, you know, drive from events and stuff like that. But I mean, I have a daily, so there's no reason for me to drive this thing daily. All right, so I got the seats just lightly thrown back in there, and later on today when I'm out, I'm gonna go get myself some lock washers, but you guys understand the concept. Throw the seats back in, throw the lock washer on, and then throw the bolt right through and tighten her up. But a lot of people always ask what color was the car originally that didn't follow me or know what color the car was originally. And the car was like pearl blue, I believe is the color. It's got a whole bunch of flake and stuff like that, OEM. It's not bad. This is super dusty, so you can't really see it that well. But as far as the wrap job goes, my buddy Weta Wraps wrapped this car. And I mean, he did an amazing job the whole way around. There's like no complaints, you know, that's a perfect seam. And since the car's blue, it's why it's so hard for the camera to pick up, because you can't really see, like, the differentiate. I mean, with the camera you can now in this angle, but you really can't tell when you open the door. It literally looks like the same. So that's what I really like about it. But as far as the taillights go, so for future upgrades for this car, soon I want to, if anyone has Euro LED tails, actual Euro LED tails, bang my line, because before I go and get some, like, OEM ones, or just go shell out like $300 or whatever it is for like the Euro tails, bang my line, because I bought some Euro tails a while back and they actually were not real. So I was like, I'm not even gonna throw these in. Like, they're a little bit different colors and all that trash. So that was like 2017 I bought those, and they're just sitting in the basement. But yeah, so if anyone has Euro LED tails, I was thinking about maybe trying to get like a spoiler of some sort, just like a little, like, little duck bill for the back of the trunk. Throw me in the right direction for a cooler looking antenna, because I really want to just delete the antenna, which I might still do when I rewrap the car. So this car is getting rewrapped at some point. I don't know if it's going to be right away. Weta_Wraps really wants to wrap the car a whole nother color, and I'm on board with that, but I need a car for content. So it's hard, and I also want to get body work and stuff done. So I was thinking about, you know, like I said in previous videos, about getting another build, something that we can completely do through. Because this car, it's not done. There's some more stuff to be done to it, but there's like not like, you know, every day I can't make a video. I really want a car where I can like throw a bigger turbo on and injectors and all that stuff. So like something we can have a lot of fun with. And as far as the front goes, you know, the hood's been destroyed from, I don't know if you guys have seen the video of the pumpkin that I put on the hood, but, you know, the pumpkin melted the wrap and stuff like that, so that's soot that's, like, melted into the wrap. But, I mean, it's no big deal, it's just vinyl wrap, and Weta Wraps will get us right. He wanted to fix that months ago, but I'm like, if we're rewrapping the car, we may as well not even, because it's winter over here. Like, right now, I don't know if you can see my face, just because, like, how the camera adjusts, but there's snow on the ground. We got snow over there. Right now, it's 33 degrees, like, just on the cusp of freezing. Like, my hands are moving slowly. Like, I'm out here in the cold. But, yeah, I've got these, like, black housing headlights and stuff like that. I really want to do a car walk around. Everyone keeps asking for it. Just the car I want to have in the proper lighting. I have it in the garage. You know, it's not ideal lighting for the car for, like, a video like that and all that stuff. But I don't know. I ordered the Heim joints for those toe arms, so we should be getting that pretty soon, and we can make the Heim joint toe arm video. But I was like, while I'm at it, like, I may as well get Heim joints for the control arms. So I'm thinking about making Heim joint rear control arms using the stock control arm, because it has this bucket. I don't know if you can see it in there, but the bucket that holds the bag, it's all, you know, mapped out and ready to go, and it's perfect. So why reinvent the whole wheel when I don't need to? So I'm thinking about chopping the end off and putting the Heim joint and stuff like that. So that'll be a fun video for you guys, because I love welding and stuff like that. Yeah, also, please throw down in the comments, comment down below, and tell me what color you guys think I should wrap this car. Purple is my favorite color, purple and black. I mean, that's the whole concept of this car, is purple and black. But there's so many other color options, and I want to be open to other color options, because I know you guys would be interested in other color options. So throw it down in the comments, and If you see a color that someone has already put down, also put that color so I can see how many people want to see that color. And yeah, you guys would love that. I can't wrap anything more in this car, really. I want to maybe wrap the dash, but that's a whole undertaking. And, you know, because I already wrapped all the door cards and stuff. But, yeah, this garage has terrible lighting. It's really hard for me to make videos in here and keep turning the camera around. I'm learning that. So I'm thinking about maybe relighting this whole garage. So if you guys want to see a video where I'm just relighting the garage and changing stuff up, let me know, because, you know, I love video ideas, but I don't know what the viewers want to watch. If you guys want to see a video where I'm relighting the garage, let me know. And, yeah, this was just a shorter video just showing you guys some basic stuff, but there's a lot more to come. And I'm thinking about maybe making diffusers for this car and stuff like that. So, man, there's so many video ideas. It's just harder out here in the cold, so that's why I haven't been pumping out videos every day. Like, I'm super excited for the spring because we'll be able to work outside. Like, I know people work outside in the cold, but, like, to be making videos in the cold and stuff like that, it's just not fun. And videos are all about having fun, so I'm limited to just this garage space right now. And I'm sorry for this being mainly a talking video. It's just the seat. I had figured out the issue so quickly, and there's more stuff. Like, I want to make a back, like a close off for the back, basically, because I'm running no back seat at the moment. So you can see right back there, I've actually got Volkswagen CC seats in the back, a 2015 CC my friend had, and he got rid of it, and he sold me the seats, so I got those. And I want to make a block off plate. There's so many video ideas. So please throw it down in the comments for video ideas that I could do with this, because, man, there's just so many. I go blank sometimes. But man, I'm so excited. I just want it to be spring so I could pump out a video every day and, like, work on cars outside and eventually get my own shop. And it doesn't have to be big. I really want a place where I can have at least three content cars, and we could just make so many fun videos and stuff like that. And I ramble just because, like, I just keep thinking of stuff as I talk, and I'm just so excited for, like, this whole, like, YouTube thing. And man, I'm just waiting for those Heim joints to come in so I can make that welding video for you guys. And I know I said I wanted to use the existing tube for the Heim joints, and I want to make a whole new arm. So I'm thinking about also ordering the swedge, or I think that's what it's called. It's called a swedge. And basically, it's right here. It's this middle piece that these bolt into. So you can get just the Heim joints, obviously, and then get the bungs that go into them, and then you can make any piece of metal, like, usable. But they also sell, like, pre-threaded swedges. I'm pretty sure they're called swedges, as weird as it sounds. But it's just hard finding a steel one. They're all aluminum. So I've just been like, maybe I'll just use this existing one. But it's only 7.5 inches, so I only have 11 threads that are threaded in there. And like ECS said, I believe it was 8 is, like, good enough. So I might just run what I have ordered, but I really want to get those other swedges in and make a whole video of it being, like, nice and new parts and stuff like that. But yeah, I'm sorry. I'm going to say it again. I'm sorry that this was more of a talking video and more of, like, an update video. But I'm just overly excited to get something new. Once the channel gets, like, monetized, I'll be able to go ahead and like, make that jump to buy a like, basically another channel car, you know? So, close these doors up. Didn't lock all the way, but, you know, that's just the way it goes. But, man, I love this thing. I just wish I had more garage space and another vehicle to work on, you know? So, guys, thank you for listening to me rant. If you made it all the way to the end, let me know in the comments. And I hope everyone has a great day. If you want to follow my Instagram or my TikTok, it's @tilted_TDI. And we have lots to come, more cars, try to work on and get my parts in. So I'm done rambling, guys. Thanks for watching again. And yeah, I'm going to get another video out to you within the next day or so. So everybody stay tuned and excited.